So let me motivate you with a very personal example, and then let me talk about an abstract example. A personal example. I used to spend my vacations with my uncle and aunt. A very loving couple, very nice to hang around with them. But occasionally they used to sort of have some disagreement, and they would fight for a minute or two. And that is when I would be in a fix, for a simple reason that uncle and aunt would start controlling me. Uncle would say, "Come Sudarshan, let's go to the beach." My aunt would say, no, come, let's go shopping. I'll get you something to eat." Uncle would say, no, if you're going with your aunt, I'm not going to talk to you." Aunt would say the same, "If you are going with your uncle, I'm not going to talk to you." So I'm in a fix here. Look, I cannot go with only one person here. There will be hatred from the other person. What do I do? I cannot go with both of them. I cannot go with one of them. The best thing here is to say, call it quits. I'm not going with anyone. I'm neither going with uncle nor with aunt. This is to be on the safer side, right? All of us would have encountered such a situation in our life. You love two people equally and they ask you to take a call. Love me or love the other person. You cannot love both. So it is to so happen that I would take the excuse of I have homework, and I would sit and start scribbling something, and things would come to a standstill, and then they would become normal. This is my personal example. Let me try using an abstract example to explain the same thing. Now I just used a personal example so that people can relate to it. An abstract example. Let me consider this friend Ram and Krishna, Rama and Krishna. These two people are very close to me, let's say, very good friends, best friends, but unfortunately, they don't like each other. Here's the similar problem I told you of the uncle and aunt example. I cannot invite Rama and Krishna home for a party, for a simple reason that in case they come for the party, they would not talk to each other. Party is done to de-stress yourself. If you have two such people in the party, it will add to your stress. So what will happen? Think about it for a second. Rama and Krishna come home. They sit together. They don't talk to each other. They don't want me to talk to one person. Other person gets offended. What will I do? There are two consequences of such a thing. In my life, if I want to continue being friends with these two people, I must take a decision. Decision one, by hook or crook, make them become friends. That's a nice decision if it can work. But generally it doesn't work. Two people who hate each other would want to continue hating each other. What do? I'll try my best to make Rama and Krishna become friends with each other. I'll convince them, take them out with them. I'll play football with them, party with them. No, it may not work. If it works, well and good. If it doesn't, I'm in a fix. Why am I in a fix? It's because Rama will say, "Sudarshan, enough is enough. Stop being friends with Krishna. Otherwise, I will stop being friends with you." Krishna will tell me the same thing. So what's happening here? Think for a minute. Let me draw a picture and then observe what's happening here. Here is me. And I'm friends with Rama, I'm friends with Krishna. Rama and Krishna hate each other. Now this kind of a triangle with two lines and one dotted line representing hatred and a straight line representing friendship, is a dangerous combination. This will not continue to stay this way for a long time. Eventually, either this dotted line should become a straight line, you see what I'm saying? Either Rama and Krishna should become friends because of Sudarshan's involvement or whatever, or Sudarshan should start hating one of them. In case Sudarshan starts hating Krishna, the triangle will look like this. Sudarshan likes Rama, Rama likes Sudarshan of course, and Rama of course hates Krishna as and always. Sudarshan has started hating Krishna. This is a stable situation. The previous one was actually an unstable situation. Unstable simply because there is pressure for the structure, friendship structure to change. Now, this was with three people. Imagine there are 30 people in an organization. There's a lot of hatred, a lot of friendship. What will happen? This entire chapter is about studying this. And studying this and inferring some really cool results. Let's get started with more results right now. I will now make an attempt to enumerate all possible cases. What do I mean by all possible cases? You see, there are three people, A, B and C. Between A, B and C, what all are possible? Three friendships are possible, as you can see. Case 1. Case 2. Two friendships and one hatred. This is case 2. What's the next case, as you can guess? Two hatred, one friendship. The fourth case is all three hatreds, right? Let us take this one at a time and then observe what are the consequences of these cases. What are the cases that are stable? What are the cases that are unstable? I hope you are following what I mean by stable and unstable. By stable, I mean this kind of a friendship doesn't have any dangers. For example, three friendships. I mean, there's no problem there at all. Versus the case that I told you a while before, Ramakrishna case, what you can see here. Two friendships, one hatred. Now that's dangerous. It is unstable. Eventually, something will happen to this kind of a triangle, right? Either it should become a complete three friendships or two hatred, one friendship, as discussed earlier. What I'll do right now is I'll go slowly with all these cases and see what case has what consequence. So, first case, three friendships, a happy world. Need I say more? Three people who are friends with each other, I mean, they have a wonderful life. There is absolutely no hatred between anyone, period. There is nothing to study here, at least in this chapter. Three friendships is stable. There is no pressure similar to my Ramakrishna example. That's a tough life. Here is a happy life. Now, what if there is three hatreds? A, B and C. These three people hate each other. By the way, let me ask you a question. Remember triadic closure? A friend's friend is a friend. Do you think an enemy's enemy is an enemy? Think about it. A friend's friend is a friend. The same rule applies here. It is in fact true that an enemy's enemy is actually an enemy. Think about it. Am I right? Just because the professor says something, it needn't be right. Pause for a second, analyze the situation and tell me, is it really true that enemy's enemy is an enemy? If you are not clear, just watch this video clip and come back and I'm sure you will understand what is wrong with this statement. Enemy's enemy is an enemy.